Old Man John the Melter. Old Man John the Melter wouldn't tap steel till it was right, and he let the superintendents rave. He didn't give a damn about tonnage, but he did give a damn about steel. So they put him on the street, and the steel got sorrier and sorrier, and rails got to breaking under trains. The railroads quit buying, and the mill shut down. And then the superintendents asked Old Man John to come and tell them what was wrong with the steel. And he told them, too many superintendents. Who's America, somebody asked, and is this the answer? Another old man with a face you also have seen. A face you have seen getting out of limousines at the bank entrance or the War Department. Berserk cop with the brandished club, the armored bus spraying gas on the pickets, the mobbing howl of the press and the rabies in Congress, to the electric chair with the strikers. Who's America anyhow? Of work in slavery, of hope for life at last and justice beyond the spaded unmarked grave. The platform dignitaries of master race, stooping for the occasion, were suddenly shamed and shaken by these fierce and singing children, chanting out their stormy hunger for freeborn rights still wickedly denied. The style is new. The abominations of his war moved Lincoln to unmanly tears. Perhaps he pondered scripture over much. We too bring God into our speeches. Question we spout as well, to poke our naked sword in words of righteous tone. Small matter if the skeptical are unconvinced. We have the countervailing force to make them cringe. Power makes us stoop to parley. Loud as pterodactyls in their prime are we. Mighty as mammoths, whose unrivaled thews the tundra lies in ice perpetual.
What would I do if I were a black man? And I keep thinking of these two who died, one on land and one at sea, murdered. If I were a black man, I would swear the same oath I'm swearing now, to avenge these men and all the men like them, and the women and children, white, black, yellow and brown, whose blood cries out for vengeance all over the world. Being a black man would change nothing. These same men would be my brothers. But brothers are not known by the color of their skins, but by what is in their hearts, backed up by their deeds and by their lives.
When it comes to that,